18 July 2022. Morning, Murli. Am Shanti. BapDada. Madhuban. Sweet children, you are now being taken beyond with the father's glance. To be taken beyond means to become a master of heaven. Question: who can put into practice the direction to break away from everyone else and to connect oneself to only the one? Answer: those who have the aim and objective clearly in their intellects. Your aim and objective is to go the land of liberation. You have to remove your intellects yoga even from your own body and practicing in silence beyond talkie and movie, because you have to go into silence, that is into nirvana, means the land beyond sound. Song: why should the moth not die? Am Shanti. You children know in whose vision you are sitting. You are sitting in front of your Parlokic Supreme Father, the Supreme Soul. You know that by coming into the vision of this Baba, you claim your inheritance of heaven for 21 births. When you go to a sage or holy man, people say he will take you beyond with just a glance. However, no one apart from you Brahmins can understand about being taken beyond with a glance. You are now sitting in Baba's vision. The children are in the father's vision, and the father is in the children's vision. Your children are taken beyond with the father's glance. Only from the father you receive the inheritance. You are unlimited children. You are sitting in his vision. You are truly listening to a few words. Constantly remember me alone, and you will be taken beyond. That is, you will become the masters of heaven. He truly takes you beyond in a second and grants you liberation and liberation in life. He is the incorporeal Supreme Father, the Supreme Soul. He knows that you have come here and became his children. Those who have the firm faith that they are children of Supreme Father, the Supreme Soul, will definitely become the masters of heaven. You have to go beyond with a glance and also become the masters of heaven. In heaven, you have sovereignty, whereas everyone here is a master of hell. That is, all are restaurants of hell, and their status is number wise in that too. Though there are no kingdoms now, they understand in their hearts, I was a master of Jaipur. They even write Maharaja of Jaipur, Maharaja of Patiala. They are called thus. They themselves are still alive, and their clan is also alive. They too have now become part of the people. You now know that you are once again establishing a self-sovereignty by following Srimad. The father has explained that the same Bharat was pure and that it has now become impure. Each of you has now received a third eye. The soul knows, I now remember the one Supreme Father, the Supreme Soul, and I receive the inheritance from him. God speaks, remember me and break away from everyone else. Break away from even your own body. Become bodiless. You first came bodiless. All souls are bodiless because souls are bodiless in the incorporate world. There is no sound there. That is why it is called the land beyond sound. There is movie in the subtle world. There is talkie, movie and silence. Previously, there just used to be movie films, but they have now become talkie. Your children are taught silence. Stabilize yourselves in your original religion and remember your home. Stop talking. You mustn't even buzz anything. They chant the name of Ram internally. The father says, "Children, now stop that too. You have to go beyond sound. While living here, you have to go beyond talkie and movie. You have the aim and objective clearly in your intellect that you have to go to the land of liberation. Baba gives you liberation and liberation in life. At first, all souls go into silence, and then each one has to come to play his part. Those of the Rita religion have their own parts, and those of Islam and Buddhism have their own parts. Your children have all of these things in your intellects. The father has all of this knowledge, and so he tells you all of this knowledge and makes you similar to himself. You then have to make others the same as you. You have to make them knowledgeable and yogi. I give you the knowledge that I have. It is you souls that imbibe knowledge and become knowledgeful, number-wise according to your efforts. Some become completely knowledgeful, whereas others don't become as knowledgeful because they make less effort. The aim and objective is Lakshmi and Narayan. You are now becoming knowledgeful. You now know where you have come from and where you have to go and how the cycle turns. Everything is included in this. A tree emerges from a seed and its lifespan is so long that it reaches the state of total decay. We had a tree here which was completely decayed. And so we had to chop it down. There is the example of the banyan tree. The tree that is shown is of the variety of religions. They will all continue to come, little by little, till the end. The leaves that first emerge are very beautiful because they are satapradhan. They then become rajo and tamo. You rule the kingdom for half the cycle, and then you gradually come down. There are the stages of ascend and descend. You ascend very quickly. It takes a little time for the whole kingdom to be established. The father explains, "I myself come at the confluence age and establish the deity kingdom. The sun dynasty and moon dynasty kingdoms are only established at this time so that you then go to the new world of the land of immortality and have the fortune of your kingdom. This is called the confluence age. No one else comes at the confluence age. Only the father comes. It is not mentioned in the scriptures when I come again. No one is able to know this. Only your children know this. This part is played every cycle. The whole tree becomes old and its foundation is now being laid at the confluence age. Thus is the impure world. The golden age is the pure world. The saints come and make us impure ones pure. You are all now becoming pure and you will be pure when you come down again. However, not everyone will come down together." The father explains to you so well. That principle is now sitting here. Therefore, why should this knowledge not be given to everyone so that everyone can know what the history and geography of the world are and how they repeat? No one knows that God is one. There is no other creator, nor is there another world up above or down below. When they speak of above the sky and below the ocean, those are all lies. The belief that there is a world beyond the stars. However, there isn't anyone's kingdom there. Baba even tells this principal child, explain thus history and geography to those who are good students. Also approach the government. Explain to the senior officers. However, you have to explain very tactfully that there was the kingdom of the original, eternal deity religion in the golden age. How did they gain their kingdom? They have shown in the scriptures. that what took place between the deities and the devils, and that the deities won. There was only one Mahabharat war. There was no war after that. The father says, give this knowledge to the children in schools. When someone invents something, he first shows it to the king, and then its production grows through him. The soul receives the knowledge of the beginning, the middle, and the end of the world cycle, through which he becomes a ruler of the globe for 21 births. There are also many among you who aren't educated. Baba says that is very good. There were those who were educated, but they couldn't pass this examination. Here it is a matter of a second. There was the kingdom of Lakshmi and Narayan in the golden age. The kingdom of Ram and Sita begins in the silver age. The path of devotion starts after half the cycle. They have to stumble around. People even say, oh God, the Father. Therefore, you should definitely receive the inheritance of heaven from him. When a person dies, people ask where he has gone, and some reply, he has gone to heaven. The belief that heaven is up above in the sky. They have become so senseless. This is a forest of thorns. Bharat alone was a garden of flowers. You are now becoming flowers. The father explains, never cause sorrow for anyone. If you cause sorrow for anyone, you will die in sorrow. You won't be able to claim a high status. You know that you have come to Baba in order to claim the inheritance of constant happiness. You have become Brahmins. Brahmins are remembered as the most elevated. The symbol of Brahmins is the top knot. Who is the father of Brahma? It is corporeal Shiv, shivbaba and Prajapita, father of humanity. Brahma is in the corporeal form. What should we keep as a symbol of shivbaba? The supreme father, the supreme soul, is a star. But because of not knowing this, people have created a large lingam image. How can a point be worshipped? There is also the worship of Rudra. They make a large image of Rudra, Shiv, and small saligrams. They even speak of a star in the center of the forehead. People even have visions of a soul. When a star breaks up in the sky, everything around it appears white. In the same way, a soul is also point. He comes and enters such a big body and then does so much work through it. When such a tiny soul leaves his body, the body is unable to do anything. It would be said that he or she has died. The soul sheds body, takes another and plays a part. And so there is no need to cry. However, only when they know the drama can they say this. You now know that you will shed your old costumes and go to your land of Nirvana, means land beyond sound. You have this knowledge here. So then you have to go to the big schools and colleges and give this knowledge to the seniors. There used to be the Sun Dynasty and Moon Dynasty kingdoms in Bharat. They don't exist anymore. They will definitely exist again. This is the eternal world drama. Children should definitely have knowledge of it. By them having this knowledge, Bharat becomes heaven. Now, because they don't have this knowledge, Bharat is poverty stricken. We are once again making Bharat into heaven with this knowledge. Why should those children do not take this knowledge and become worthy of heaven? You too can become this. No one should be left out. Baba shows you many ways to do service. It is your children who have to do it. The father will not go anywhere. Acha. To the sweetest, beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance, and good morning from the mother, the father, BapDada. The spiritual father says namaste to the spiritual children. The spiritual children says namaste and good morning to the spiritual father. Essence for the dharana. First point, remain stable in your original religion and experience silence because it is now time to go to nirvana, the land beyond sound. Second point, you are the children of the bestower of happiness. Therefore, give everyone happiness. Do not cause sorrow for anyone. Become a true flower. Do service and change thorns into flowers. Blessing. May you be a master almighty authority who is full of all the powers and who uses every power. Explanation. The children who are constantly full of all the powers are master almighty authorities. If a particular power cannot be used at a time of need, you cannot be called a master almighty authority. If even one power is lacking, you will be deceived at that time and you will fail. Do not think that you have all the other powers. And so, what does it matter if one power is missing? Everyone matters because even one would fail you. Therefore, do not let even one power be missing and use that power at the right time. You will then be called a master almighty authority. Slogan. To forget your attainments is to become tired, and so always keep your attainments in front of you. Om Shanti. Invaluable elevated virgins of Mateshwariji. When we say the word Om, it means I am a soul and a child of God. The name Shiv belongs to only the one God, and many people ask questions about this word. God is the master or the father of the whole world. So why is he called Shiv? The world does not know the secret. God's name is Shiv because there are innumerable religions in the world, and those of each religion call him by different name. In fact, in Bharat, God is remembered as Shiv. So, how will those living abroad in the whole world believe in God with the name Shiv? It is explained that, in fact, God's name is Shiv, his form is light, and his memorial is worship in the form of Shivlingam. In fact, there is more worship of this form in Bharat because God took birth in the land of Bharat. And so, this land would definitely be mentioned. God would definitely come in one place. If he were to come abroad, how would those in Bharat believe in him? However, the name of the land of Bharat is very well known. It is remembered as an imperishable land, and this is why God himself has to come here. God's elevated virgins are, when there is extreme definition of religion in Bharat, it is then that I come to destroy irreligiousness and to establish the religion of truth. I carry out this task by incarnating only once. So God's incarnation is in Bharat, where he came in the previous cycle. He has to come in the same place again, and this is why Bharat is called an imperishable land. The land of Bharat is God's birthplace, and it is also the place of the kingdom of deities. Acha Om Shanti.